Sonny Liston, The Life and Times. First round. It is hard to imagine, especially in today's world that we live in, that a sport as rough and violent as boxing once dominated the professional sports world scene. There was an era in boxing when being the heavyweight champion of the world meant that you were the best in the world. The title of world champion should only apply if the athlete or team has actually faced international opponents and won. Professional sports continues to grossly misuse the glory and esteem that comes with being globally recognized as one of the best of all time in a sport. In boxing, the name Sonny Liston is still synonymous with the greatest boxers of all time. Liston's size and powerful hands propelled him to the top of the boxing world, and despite his early and suspicious death, pound for pound he is still regarded amongst the sports's elite. From his humble beginnings, to his rise to greatness, and ending with his tragic death, this is the story of the legendary Sonny Liston, one of the greatest boxers of all time. Sonny's humblest of beginnings. Quite sadly, Charles Sonny Liston entered the world while his sharecropping parents worked on a plantation. This was also at a time when birth certificates were not yet mandatory, and as a result of no official record of his date of birth being available, his official age is still a mystery decades after his passing. With that kind of start to the world, it was no wonder that Liston's life would take him down a dark path that would foreshadow the end of his life. Liston's mother fled the abuse of Toby Liston, Sonny's father, and took some of his siblings to St. Louis, Missouri. Sonny wanted to join his mother and himself to escape the reach of his father's abuse. Liston raised enough money selling pecans that he had thrashed to rejoin his mother, all at the ripe age of 14. Jail and boxing? Liston was illiterate, and this did not allow him to apply for meaningful, sustainable employment. Instead, he had to resort to being an underling of the criminal underworld to make ends meet. Liston led a gang of thugs who committed robberies and violent assaults for money until he was caught and sentenced to 5 years in prison in 1950. He reported his age to be 20, but it was widely believed that Sonny was 22 years of age when he went away to jail. Little did Liston know that being convicted and going to prison would change his life for the better forever. It was while serving his sentence that Liston was discovered by the athletic director of the prison and encouraged to enter the squared circle. An early parole, impressive sparring session as his audition, and less than a year under his belt as an amateur boxer, Sonny Liston turned professional almost a year after being released from jail. October 31, 1952. Liston walked through the front gates of Missouri State Penitentiary as a free man, having only served 2 of the 5 years that he was sentenced to initially. Liston turns pro. Sonny Liston signed his first professional boxing contract in September 1953. Once again, Liston found himself turning to the criminal underworld to help him along his path. The only financial support that Liston could manage to get was from the earnings he obtained racketeering for the mafia. Standing at 6 feet and 1 inch, with a reach of 84 inches, and fists that were charted at 15 inches around, Sonny Liston was an intimidating force in the heavyweight division. It was not until Liston's 8th professional fight that he would get his first loss. Marty Marshall's only claim to fame will be the answer to the trivia question: who was the first boxer to defeat Sonny Liston? Marshall defeated Liston on September 7, 1954. A bout in which it is suspected that Liston lost the fight because he was punched while laughing at Marshall, breaking Liston's jaw. To his credit and toughness, Liston remained in the fight before losing at the end of the match's 5 rounds on a split decision. Liston would quickly erase that loss from the record books by beating Marshall badly in a convincing 6th-round knockout. After a return to prison in 1956 following the assault of a police officer, Liston served 6 of the 9-month term, and was banned from boxing during the year of 1957. Liston left prison and bolted for Philadelphia to restart his life and boxing career. Liston would knock out 6 of the 8 fighters that he faced in 1958. Deemed by many as the number one contender to face the heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson, Liston was denied initial attempts to secure a title fight with Patterson due to his criminal past. Heavyweight champion of the world, Sonny Liston. Patterson avoided defending his belt to Liston for 2 years, and even had a strong recommendation from then-President of the United States, John F. Kennedy, not to fight Liston based on his criminal activities. Patterson would eventually agree to battle Liston on September 25, 1962 at Comiskey Park in Chicago. Liston only needed until the 2:06 mark of the bout to knock out Patterson out for the heavyweight title. Patterson would go on to lose the rematch to Liston, and have to accept that he did not have anything to counter the power of Liston. Ali vs. Liston, Part 1 and 2. Young, brash, cocky, upstart Muhammad Ali faced Liston in what was supposed to be one of the fights of the century. Controversy would plague the fight as both Ali and his trainer Angelo Dundee claimed that a foreign substance had somehow got into the eyes of Ali during the fight. Ali fought off the burning sensation that he felt in his eyes to defeat Liston via a technical knockout in the 7th round. To the surprise of nobody, the rematch between Ali and Liston would be dripping with controversy by the end of the bout, much like the first. Unlike the original contest, there were no foreign chemicals or substances involved, but instead the fight ended with many claiming that there was a fixing of the match. Several eyewitness accounts state that Ali is overheard saying that nobody would believe the phantom punch that Liston went down from at Ali's hand. Ali accosted Liston and urged him to get up and fight. Not too many people who attended the fight can admit to seeing the knockout blow that allegedly felled Liston. It did not take long for Liston's affiliations to organized crime to surface as the main reason for his taking a supposed dive in the fight. One last punch. Liston won his final fight in 1970 when he pummeled Chuck Wepner for 9 rounds, opening up cuts over his opponent's eyes which would need 72 stitches afterwards to repair. Liston inflicted so much damage on Wepner that Wepner suffered a detached retina in the fight, which forced him to retire from the sport of boxing. Co by heroin? On January 5, 1971, Sonny Liston's dead body was discovered by his wife in their Las Vegas home. As was the case with most of his life and sordid career, how Liston died remains a controversial topic. Those who knew Liston and were close to him say that he was deathly afraid of needles and that his alleged heroin overdose death was not only false, but highly suspicious considering his phobia. Others knew of Liston's involvement with organized crime, as well as his affliction for alcohol and drug use, making his death less of a surprise to them. 12th round. Regardless of all of the innuendo, criminal activity, and humble beginnings, Sonny Liston would use his gifts from God to become one of the world's greatest boxers of all time. Liston's unmatched physical power and features fueled him to a dominating career littered mostly with knockouts and mutilation of his opponents. His lack of an education and criminal pursuits would interrupt Liston's brilliant boxing career a few times along the way, but never was there any doubt about his greatness. Liston's legacy may be linked to crime, however, it is impossible to mention the legends of the sport of boxing without referencing the name Sonny Liston.